Hi guys, what's up? Welcome back to our YouTube channel. In this video, we are trying to answer a very interesting question. The question is, how to learn and get proficient at Linux being a complete beginner? With a step-by-step approach, starting from a complete beginner to the field of computer science, to a complete expert in Linux. Let's see the plan in more details with how to start, what to learn, in which order to learn them, and possible time estimates to each step in the plan. So sit back and join me in the journey. Before we see what this long road consists of, let's start with what lies at the end of this road. Once you have completed all the steps, you will be able to do anything in the world of Linux, which include but not limited to the following. You can get any Linux certification with minimum preparation. You can do any job that needs Linux knowledge. You can start your own company based on Linux. You can make your own distro. You can configure and compile the Linux kernel to run on any hardware platform with enough resources. You can contribute to Linux source code. And you will be able to work on any and all operating system, not just limited to Linux. A note on recommended resources. Time is valuable, so don't waste it on bad study materials. We have handpicked the best books and online courses we could find, and we have divided these recommended resources into three categories. The three categories are short reads, reference books, and online courses. We suggest you to read the short reads cover to cover first and keep the reference books for when you need to solve a more specific problem. And if you have time now, you can go ahead and read the reference book as well. If you are a visual learner like me and into online courses, then we have provided some courses which we believe are of high quality. We suggest you to give it a look. You can find the article with all our recommended resources in the link given in the description below. The concepts you will be learning in each of these steps are the following. And these are the 10 steps we have promised you. Step number 1 is data structures and algorithm. Step 2 is computer programming. Step 3 is software architecture. Step 4 is hardware architecture. Step 5 is operating system concepts. And step 6 is software management. Are you ready for step 7? Step 7 is GNU utilities and bash scripting. Step 8 is Linux system programming. Step 9 is driver programming. And step 10 is Linux kernel programming. The path you must take must start with the learning all the core concepts of computer science which are used to build Linux before you are ready to start learning Linux. These are the core concepts of computer science that are used to build Linux. In other words, these are the prerequisites of learning Linux. Let's look at each of these 10 steps in more details to give you an idea of what concept you will be learning in each steps. Step number 1, data structures and algorithms. This is the core of computer science. No matter what particular area of computer science you are in, and no matter what particular problem you are trying to solve, there will be some sort of data structure and algorithms involved in it. This will challenge your ability to solve problems and produce solutions that are most optimal. If you are a complete beginner to computer science, I suggest you to start with this subject. Examples use of algorithm in Linux is kernel's implementations of the schedulers, which schedules processes based on various criteria using algorithm. Step number 2, computer programming. Once you have gathered enough knowledge on algorithm and data structures, computer programming is going to be an easy task. I recommend you to start with C programming language, as it is the language used by Linux and all other operating systems. Once you have mastered C, I suggest you to proceed to Python, the object-oriented programming language with lots of open source software and learning resources online. You can build many powerful Linux apps using Python. Step number 3, software architecture and design patterns. Software architecture is all about designing good softwares, which is easy to read, modify, and maintain. It is all about learning and applying good engineering principles. I have worked with the projects that had good designs and bad designs. I completely hated my job when I was working with a poorly designed software, and I loved my job when I was working with the good design. I believe this is a universal feeling among software developers. This is due to the fact that nicely designed software is easier to understand, add features to, solve bugs, and maintain. Step number 4, computer hardware. You may be thinking, when you are working with an operating system like Linux, why you should learn hardware? A logical question. The main job of any operating system is to abstract the hardware, and as such, the basic knowledge of hardware is essential. You don't need to learn this one in too much details, just get some basics strong. And then you can move on to the next one. Step number 5, operating system concepts. Linux is an operating system, and hence it is absolutely essential to start learning what operating systems are. What is their place in computer science, and what feature and capabilities they provide to the end user. These are just a group of programs and algorithms whose collective duty is to virtualize the available hardware resources and manage them. To give you a simple analogy, operating systems are similar to manager in the modern office environment. Its duty is to manage the work performed by all the employees of the organization. A good manager will be able to satisfy the client's needs of the company. Similarly, a good operating system will provide a nice experience to the end users, us, to use the computer and make it do what we want it to. Let's check the 3 main activities of an operating system. So the 3 main activities of an operating systems are virtualization, so that the application programmer need not to worry about CPU and memory. Concurrency, to run multiple program in parallel manner. Persistence, to keep the files and data from getting corrupted and to maintain a good working condition. Remember those days where you need to reinstall the operating system and reinstall all the apps and copy the data from backup every few months to keep the computer working smoothly. The last point is about avoiding that. Step number 6, software management. So the next step in the path is to learn software management skills. When I say software management, I don't mean project management, which is development plans and meetings. Rather, I mean version control and development operations. Let's check these two out first. What is version control? Tool and techniques used for managing and keeping tracks of the changes you make during software development is basically version control. In software engineering, when you build a project, you can often find yourself in a place where something which was working perfectly fine suddenly breaks because you changed some lines of code recently. This is where the version control software like Git comes in. Here, every change you make will be recorded and you can easily see the exact changes you did and undo those changes if needed. This will save a ton of time, so I recommend you to learn a bit about it. I myself had wasted days trying to figure out the change I made that crashed the machine. But once I started using the version control system, I was much more efficient. Now, I can't imagine writing a code without the version control system. What is DevOps? DevOps stands for Development Operations, which involves two steps, namely continuous integration and continuous delivery. When you are working on a large team, like say on a Linux kernel project, you need to be able to test the code from the contributors before adding them to the project. Manually testing each and every change is time consuming and also an inefficient process. This is where development operations comes in. It helps you to automate this process of testing and integrating changes made by your team members to the project and then releasing the software to the end customers. Once you have learned all these concepts we have checked so far, your skill set is at the level of any software developer. The next step is to join the big boys and start learning Linux. This road will be an easy one, as you have already a very good foundational knowledge on computer science. Linux is basically five parts. The parts are the Linux kernel, drivers, GNU utilities that comes with the operating system, Bash scripting to control and automate the system using the GNU utilities, the various APIs for writing your own apps on Linux, be it a command line app, desktop app, smartphone app, embedded app, or a cloud app. Step number 7, GNU utilities and bash scripting. Even though this is the fourth on our list, I recommend learning this one first. Basically, as you learn bash, you will learn a lot about Linux and GNU utilities that it comes with. And it's a lot of fun. What is GNU? The name GNU is a recursive acronym for GNUs, not Unix. GNU is pronounced as GNU. It is a collection of many programs, applications, libraries, developer tools, and games whose source code is on the internet for everyone to see and improve upon. What is Bash? Bash is the GNU's replacement for the famous Unix shell BSH, which stands for Bourne Shell, named after its developer. Bash stands for Born Again Shell, again a wordplay. It is the text-based user interface for users to interact with the operating system. Then, what is a shell? In olden days, there was no graphical desktop user environment and users only had a text-based interface to the operating system called a shell. These days, professional users still prefer the shell to the graphical user interface because of its simplicity and efficiency. It is a powerful tool for interacting with operating system and hence it is very important to learn it. Step number 8, Linux systems programming. So now you know how to use Bash and other GNU utilities to automate processes. This is the next piece of the puzzle, which is to learn how to talk to the kernel and the hardware to make the hardware to do what we need to do. Essentially, here you are learning to build programs that are on the same level as the GNU utilities. Examples of such programs include Disk Management Utility, Network Management Utility, Task Manager, Device Manager, GUI Interface, etc. Step number 9, Drivers. So far, you have mastered the command line. You can make your own applications and system programs. The next step is to learn how to add hardware to your system. In order for the kernel to control the newly added hardware, it needs a program to talk to that can act as an interface between the kernel and the hardware of these programs are called as drivers. What are device drivers? These are the programs that act as an interface between the given hardware and the kernel of the operating system. Just as our system programs are considered part of the operating system, device drivers are part of the kernel. In other words, if you want to add some custom hardware to your Linux machine, then you need to write the driver code for it and to load the code into the machine so that kernel can control your custom hardware. So to do that, you need to learn how to write Linux drivers. Step number 10, Linux kernel programming. This is the last piece of the puzzle, the Linux kernel. So far, you have learned to talk to kernel directly via system programs, indirectly via user applications, and you have managed to add your own piece of code to the kernel via Linux drivers. The next step is to understand the inner mechanism of the kernel itself, so that you can understand it better and you can port the kernel to other hardware if you need to. So, what is a kernel? It is the core of any operating system, and its duty is to the management of resources like CPU, memory, and I/O, and allocate them to the processes that ask for it in an efficient manner, so that high priority processes and low priority processes can coexist and share the system resources. So if you're interested in the end result listed at the beginning of this video and want to master Linux, then this is what it takes to get there. You can either look at it as a lot of pending work or as an endless hours of fun over the next couple of years. But hey, once you have done it, you are as knowledgeable as any computer science graduate is. And you will be able to do pretty much anything in the world of Linux. Alright, I guess that covers all the steps. Go ahead in the link in the description below where we have listed out all our recommended study materials and start your journey of mastering Linux. If you would like to learn more about embedded system, visit our website embeddedinventor.com. If you have any questions and suggestions for the future video, leave them in the comment section below. If you like this video, please hit the like button. If you are new to this channel, consider subscribing. Thank you for watching, and I will see you inventors in the next one.